Hello everyone and welcome back to more Clannad. In the last episode, Sunohara got his fortune told that he would no longer have such problems in his life and he would meet the love of his life, whom he's absolutely convinced that he accidentally ran into around the corner, and he was running for the classroom, and apparently she's probably here in the doorway ready to kill him. All of a sudden, the door slides open violently. Who could it be? I don't know, let's find out. And there stands, if I remember correctly, that's one of the third years from the rugby club. You can clearly see he's pretty pissed. Oh, that's a dude. Sunohara lets out a soft shriek and hides behind me and Q.
Oi, kono kyoushitsu ni kinpatsu no yarou ga nigete konakatta ka?
Yeah, he's right here. You and I each take a step away from each other. Then we point at the space in between us. God, I love that scream. So satisfying. Sunohara gets dragged out of the room. His life of hardships will soon come to an end, eh? Right. That's true. Yeah. The two of us continue to gaze at the open door for a while. Oh boy. The bell rings to signal the start of afternoon classes. I'm taking my seat. Annoyed that I'm stuck at this desk for the next however long. I don't know how long are these classes. I don't even pay attention. Never go to them. Hearing the same sound, Kyo dashes out of the classroom. I kind of liked Kyo. Hope I'll see more of her.
Oi, Okazaki.
A voice calls out to me right as the period ends, but I quickly realize it's just my teacher's. Like a good student, I decide to ignore.
聞こえないのか, Okazaki?
So persistent! What is it? What do you want? I raise my head while answering him, a tone of distrust and annoyance heard in my voice. My homeroom teacher walks right up to me.
Sunohara-wa-doko-da?
I don't know, probably in the bathroom. Look at the desk next to mine. He's right, Sunohara's not there. Who knows? I don't know.
Sagashite-tsurete-kite-kurenai-ka?
How am I supposed to find him? I don't know where he is. Me?
そう、お前だ、岡崎。
Why? Why me?
お前なら見当がつくんじゃないのかと思ってたよ。
Well, you'd think that, wouldn't you? But I don't. Nothing coming to mind.
そうか。なら、お前を代わりに呼ぶことになるぞ。
Where am I going?
もちろん、職員室だよ。
Why?
岡崎、お前は自分の遅刻の数を知ってるのか?
Oh, man, I don't even know where to begin. Not as bad as Sunohara, though. At least I show up before lunch. Sometimes.
God damn it,
Sunohara! Look what he put me into. He had to go hit on someone else's girlfriend. What a depressing situation this is. But if it means that I can skip class after this, seems wisest to just do as he says and look for Sunohara. Okay, I understand. I'll go find him. I turn around and start walking.
Oi, Okazaki! 今からじゃないぞ! 授業が終わってからだぞ!
I pretend to not hear that last bit. Now we got plausible deniability, and I can blame him if I get scolded for skipping out on the rest of the day. We're smart like that. I'm certain that Sunohara was around during lunch, but I'm not sure if he was around to take fifth period. I slept through the whole thing. Maybe the rugby team dragged him off somewhere, probably. If that's the case, he's probably in some dark corner of the school now, never to be seen again. Boy, wouldn't that be nice. Thought makes me lose my will to find him. Huh? What? What's that sound? Someone's tapping on my back. Who the hell's tapping on my back? From armpit to the waist. Stop fucking touching me! What do you want? I turn around just in time to catch sight of a girl running away. I recognize the figure. Must be the wood carving girl I met yesterday. She's some kind of pervert. Again. I just had to stop walking and see what happens. Stop touching me. She keeps touching all over the place. Passing female student can't hold in her laughter as she looks at us. What are you looking at? Same show. That is my groin. Do not touch that. She taps there again. So you're interested in the place that much, huh? Oh my. Don't grab it. Surprised by my voice, she loses her balance and falls on her behind. Now she's standing up. Catching her should be a piece of cake now. Do we catch her? Or do we let her go? Oh, we gotta catch her. After all that, now she's turning back on me, intending to run off again? Oh no. Too slow. Got her arm. Is that the same girl? Oh, maybe it is. Got some business with me that I need to know about? Or have you finally awakened to gender differences at your age? No. The knife? You saw off that? Ugh, totally slipped my mind, but I still haven't given back the knife I took from her. Does he was searching my body for it? How about your hand? But it's still got a bandage on it. Well then, shake my hand. She's trying to endure it. Next high five. She's still trying to endure it. Very well, boxing training. You be the trainer. Just pose like this. Make her put her hands up in front of her chest. I'll punch your hand saying jab, jab, straight. So you have to reply with 1-2-1-2. Got it?
Hi.
Are you ready?
Hi.
She closes her eyes. She knows what's coming. What kind of trainer closes her eyes? Now open your eyes and brace yourself.
Hi.
Her reluctant face is now equipped with round, open eyes, making for a rather spectacular sight. Here we go.
Hi.
Well, with 100% power, ready for it?
Hi.
Jab, jab, straight. I sped things up a little by raising my voice. Quite slowly, I put the knife in her hand. She's still going at it. That's kind of cute. Look, I gave you back the knife. If you hurt yourself, I'll come and take it away again. Got it? Just be careful so you won't go through this whole ordeal again.
Hi.
Bye then. I say goodbye without looking at her face and start walking away. Ugh, wandering around at random is just getting boring. I begin to think about where he could be. Why do I care so much? Nothing comes to mind. Honestly, I don't really care where he is at this point. I can always get back to class right before it ends. I'll just go where I feel like going. Should we go to the classroom or should we check into class? Let's check into classroom. The theater club's room is right in front of me, but my attention crawls to the side. I peek inside through the glass panel on the door. There she is. Unsurprisingly, a girl is sitting inside working diligently on her carving. She seems to be a lot more attentive to her work than the first time I saw her. I guess she won't get hurt now that she's used to it. Probably. Let's just watch her just a bit longer. I decided to keep on watching. Her body, which was moving slightly, suddenly comes to a stop. And she's putting one of those fingers in her mouth. She starts looking around restlessly. And somehow through the glass panel she detects my watching eyes. Before her usual what? Even reaches my ear, she's already jumped up and ran away. Idiot. Pushing like that only makes your wound worse. I quickly enter the classroom. Alright. Corner, the girl squatting down, facing the wall with her head resting on her knees. Hey, show me your hand. Come on. Not a word. Is she trying to hide from me? Of course she's trying to hide. Just so you know, I can totally see you. You're not visible. Cautiously, she turns her head around and points a finger at herself. Yes, you. She gets up and runs away again. This time towards the outside of the classroom. This idiot, stop running around with an injury. I start chasing after her. Where did she go? From the end of the corridor, I can see a teacher walking this way.
Okazaki-ka, sonna tokoro de nani shiteru?
He asks after recognizing me. Yes, just looking for someone. Teacher asked me to.
Jigyo chuu ni ka? Hontou ka dou ka, ato de tannin ni kiite oku zo.
Of course, feel free since it's the truth. He gives a suspicious look. I don't blame him. Then just walks past. Something small is just falling behind him. Like I said, you are way too obvious. I grab her arm. Right after I do, she turns her head towards me and puts a finger to her lips to shush me. It might not be about 8 dozen to her now and be silent for a while. Finally, the teacher makes a turn at the corner and vanishes from our view. Sigh of relief. That went well. Now let's go to the infirmary. Just who are you trying to hide from? Tell me. Listen, your hand must be hurting, right? Come with me to the infirmary. Stop lying. Show me your hand. Blood must be oozing out right now. Did that stop the bleeding? Really? Show me your hand. She raises her index finger in front of my eyes. The blood seeps through the cut, making a narrow red line as a drop falls down. Quickly, she puts the finger back in her mouth and starts sucking it. Like a magician, she proudly shows me her finger again. The blood has indeed stopped, but... Do it again, but faster and with more spirit. Maybe yell yay as you do it. The blood spouts out. Wow, very nice executed. She's sucking her finger again. Isn't that cut pretty deep? You're right, it's none of our business. What are we doing here? Let's go. Like a little kid, she spills the words out with her finger still inside her mouth. I guess so. Did you just refer to yourself in the third person? Is Fuko your name?
Hi. Ibuki Fuko desu.
Fuko Ibuki.
Okashii desu ka?
Not really, I guess. Just thought it may have been your name, but wasn't sure.
So desu ka. Sore de wa.
He turns the other way and starts walking away. Go to the infirmary, you hear me? I say that just to make sure. Guess I was being too meddlesome. But I can't exactly just stand and watch she puts herself in danger like that, can I? I guess I'll go back. Just as I turn around, I remember something. There used to be a perfect place to nap in the old school building. It was the reference room of the first floor. Should we sleep, or should we return to the classroom after all? No, we gotta go back to class. They're probably like worrying about me and stuff. It's probably best if I'm actually in class, even if I just sleep through it. Even after classes are over, that idiot still doesn't show his face. That's nothing out of the ordinary for him, though, so I'm not gonna dwell on it much. I head to the drama club room by myself. Across the hallway, a number of students are making a high-pitched racket. What? Man, shut up already. I try to walk past them when someone grabs my arm.
Oi, tasukete kurenai ka?
You, what do you want? Two students are grabbing her other arm.
Judobu ni hairimashou?
Oh, I know what this is.
Danshi judobu shushou no watakushi kara mo onegai suru.
She's being enticed into the judo club again. Moreover, they've increased their numbers.
Koitsura, shitsukoi nda.
We gotta help her. We're not jerks. Shake off her hand. Okay, you guys need to shut up already. The guy looks me in the face. I stand there glaring steadily at him. The moment he gives in and averts his gaze, he tries to grab Tamayo and leave. Let's go, Tamayo. I call to her from behind. He stops. Let's go, Tamayo. I slowly repeat it once more. Tamayo nods, and the male student's hand that had been holding on to her falls down faintly. I turn my back on them and start walking. Tamayo quickly runs up to me and follows. Damn right. Even so, I'm still his upper
classman.
They respect me. I'm here for the classman too, by the way.
There's
no acting reserved at all. Though, you'd better clear up the misunderstanding later. You should probably have a rough idea of how those people misinterpreted our relationship. Sunohara's with us during break. Right now, it's just the two of us. Even worse, looks like we're about to go out somewhere.
Ah, so ka.
Right. Guess what? We're never going to actually be dating because this is not her route. You're really slow, aren't you?
Me?
I'm not really dating anyone right now, so it doesn't really matter, but like I said before, isn't your situation a little different? Really? No. What I mean is, are you aiming to join the student council? That is what you wanted, right? You forgot, didn't you? Oh my god. How can that be an ambition if you don't even know what... In that case, you wouldn't want to have strange rumors circulating around you right now, right? This is school. Rumors matter to everything. If that's what you think, you go do whatever you want. See how well that works out for you.
じゃあ、戻って撤回してくる。
She stops walking and turns around. I'm telling you, it doesn't matter to me. Even if rumors spread, they'll just go away soon enough anyway. She asks, turning only her head. I really do.
そうか.
Finally satisfied, she turns back towards me.
いちいち気にしてたら疲れるだけだからな。Exactly. 気が合うな.
We do. We do. She's actually pretty sweet. Do we? We start walking again. So how far do you plan on following me? How far does she plan on following us? Well, I think we're gonna find out in the next episode. Take it easy, everybody.